So now I want to configure a portable radio for capacity plus operation. Now, remember that the configuration for capacity plus for a mobile radio and for a portable radio is exactly the same. The same goes for IP side connect. So what you see here in the portable radio, the same will apply in the mobile radio. So first up here would obviously be things like radio ID. So we'd need to put in a unique number, which will be the radio ID. So each radio ID will have, each radio, let me say, will have a unique number, a unique radio ID. Accessories I'm not too concerned about, buttons I'm not too concerned about, text messages, telemetry, menu, privacy, all of these things are important, but not that important for the sake of this exercise. The same goes for networking as well as MDC 1200 signaling, quick call true signaling, digital emergency. However, capacity plus emergency, I'm going to come back to that. I'm going to set up all these other things first, and then I'll come back to capacity plus emergency. Phone, that's a separate subject altogether. Contacts, MDC 1200 contacts, I'm not too concerned about. Quick call true, digital, capacity plus, yes. Now, like IP side connect, capacity plus supports different types of calls. We have group call, private call, all call, a dispatch call, and a PC call. Now, at this point in time, these two are not used, but a dispatch call would be a call to a dispatch console. So potentially you could have a dispatch console which has a unique radio ID, let's say, although it's not a physical radio with transmitter receiver inside, but it would be a device sitting on the network which effectively would be a dispatch PC. The same thing goes for PC call. Now, what I'm going to do is I'm going to add in a group call. So when I add that, you can see I put in there, it gets added automatically as being call two. Let me add one more, private call. So you will see that in this case, the icon is slightly different. So we have a little one blue man sitting there. So we could give these calls logical names. So call it group one, and the other we could call it, and perhaps this one we can call it, I don't know, manager. Whatever. So, obviously, all of these would have to have a unique number and would be set up according to your requirements. So that's the actual call list, and this would be used by the radio when it makes a call. Now, we'll get to see how these things are used when we come further down in the CPS. Right, let me just collapse these things. Then it makes it easier for us to see everything. RX group list. Now, in the motor turbo, we have two types of RX group lists. There is the digital group list, so this would be for single site and IP side connect applications. Then we have a capacity plus RX group list. So effectively, what this is, it's a list of group calls to which the radio will respond. Now, what I like to do is I like to have two RX group lists. If there are two groups potentially on the system, then I like to have this. So we have list one, list two. When the radio is on list one, let's say, or channel which is associated with list 1, then it should monitor calls made to group 1. When the radio is on list 2, the radio should monitor calls made to group 2. You could add a third list and have that on list 3, the radio is a member of neither of these groups. So potentially you could have a personality, and we'll see that now. We could have a personality where the radio is on, and while it is on this personality, it will not monitor any calls to made to any groups other than all call and private call. So there are the three RX group lists. So let me collapse that so I can work down here a bit easier. So here I have the radio channel. So we have a digital channel there, a analog channel. But what I'm going to add here now is I'm going to add a capacity plus personality. Now, you will see there it is there, channel 3. Now, if I go to that's the settings of channel 3, we'll see that there are some settings here. There's various settings. But one of the things you will not see here is RX and TX frequency. The reason being is that capacity plus is a trunking-like system. The user, when they select this channel, and in fact, I don't even like to call it channel, when we select this personality, the radio doesn't, at least the user doesn't care what frequency the radio is on. The radio and somewhere between the radio and the capacity plus system, between these two things, the decision which channel to use is made. So, in effect, we could call channel 3 something else. Channel 3, we could call it group 1. So, when the radio is on this channel, the display will show group 1. When the radio is on this channel, the radio will display on the screen group 2. And we can add one more. And we can call this third one, we can call it standby. Oops. Standby. Now, and this is where that RX group lists and capacity plus personalities come into play, because what we do is in the capacity plus personality, you will see there, RX group list, we can say list 1. TX contact name, group 1. So, what we are saying here is, when the user selects capacity plus personality called group 1, the radio will monitor calls made on list 1. And if you remember back, list 1 had group 1 in it. When the user presses PTT, a call is made to group 1. Okay. So it monitors list 1, group 1. When the user presses the PTT, the radio transmits on group 1. Now, I should point this out to you here. You will see that there is another thing here called voice list, list 1. That list 1 here is not that list 1 there. This list 1 refers to this list down here, the capacity plus voice and data list. So these are actual lists of of channels. Okay, so don't get confused between that list one and that list one there. In fact, what I even suggest to do is to rename this. Call this one group one and call this one group two. Okay, perhaps a little bit better spelling than me, but give these understandable names so that you don't have problems at a later stage. Okay, so let me go and do the other two. The other two channels. So group two. Standby. And none. Okay, so those are the personalities, and okay, there are other certain settings over here. One of the things that I like to change here is color code free. So under what conditions is the user allowed to transmit? What are the channel admit criteria? And there are two choices here, channel free or color code free. I prefer color code free. Channel free, sometimes the radio can be mistaken by another signal or some sort of interference, and this can create a busy condition when in fact there is no busy condition. If you are going to use channel free, what I would suggest is to turn this value of the RSSI threshold from minus 124 dBm to something realistic like minus 90 dBm. So set this one for color code free. That's my recommendation. So these are the personalities. So this is what the user would select by changing the channel. What we need to now do is we need to come here to channel pool. Now channel pool works slightly differently from the zone. The zone is like the bank of channels. So these things inside here, the user can select them by changing the channel, by turning the channel switch. However, the channels which you put inside the channel pool cannot be selected by the user. And this is a perfect place, a logical place for us to put our channels. Okay, so I'm just going to put in the two channels. So here you will see we have virtually nothing. We have RX frequency, TX frequency. That's it. Okay, we have color code. We have some settings relating to phone. This is for the phone patch. I'll talk about that at another point in time. The same for the other channel. RX frequency, TX frequency, color code. That's it. So here we're not concerned about what is the group call, and what is the private call. All we're talking about here are the channels from the system. Now, these two channels need to be specified somewhere else. And we need to tell the radio, are these channels voice channels or are they data channels? So we need to come down here to the capacity plus voice list. And we need to say, okay, channel 1 has channel ID 1 and 2. Channel 2 has channel ID 3 and 4. These numbers here, ID 1 and ID 2, ID 3, ID 4, this comes from the repeater. This is the configuration in the repeater. So whatever you put here must match, of course, what is set up in the repeater. The other possibility is the data channel. Now, as you can see, there are none available. So if I did have any data channels in the system, I would need to put them here. So I need to come here, capacity plus data channel. So that could be channel 3. And if we come down to the capacity plus data list, because channel 3 is a data channel, how do we know it's a data channel? If we look at the icon here, you will see that the icon is slightly different to the capacity plus voice channel. So channel 3 is the capacity plus data channel, and we could add that in there. I'm not too concerned about data, so I'm just going to take it out, but I put it in there just to show you. So in terms of the overall configuration, here is what a capacity plus portable or mobile radio would look like.